Are you ready to order yet?
No, I know I want seafood, but I want to make sure my order is sustainable. And I hear eating too much of some fish can be bad for me.
I never thought about that before. I just thought fish was fish.
Some are seriously overfished and on the verge of extinction. Others are fine to eat because there are tons of them left in the sea. And then you have some fish that contain high levels of mercury that you should definitely avoid.
It's so confusing. I'm just gonna order pasta.
Don't worry, there are many tools to help you find the right fish dish. I'll have the Arctic char, please, and about your original order of farmed trout, it's fine, unless you really wanted pasta.
No, I'll have the trout, please. Phew, I love fish so much, so how do I know what to order?
You just have to pause before you purchase. Some grocery stores and restaurants make it easy by color-coding their seafood choices. Green being the best, yellow being good, and red being unsustainable. But sometimes it can be a bit tricky. There are great websites and apps that help you select seafood, like Seafood Watch. But you still have to ask some questions. Where is your salmon from, and how was it caught?
There are a lot of different types of methods for fishing. There's purse seining, there's gill netting, there's long lining, there's traps and pots, and there's trawling. If you're taking a big net and you're dragging it along the seafloor, you're going to pick up a lot of other things. So there are methods of fishing that can sort of reduce that number of fish that you don't want. So you can reduce your bycatch, which means you're having less of an impact on all those other species.
Don't let it get overwhelming. Understanding how marine ecosystems work can help you make smart choices.
We have a tradition as humans of fishing what we say high in the food chain. It's probably better to feed on species lower in food chains that are closer to the base, anchovies, sardines, herring, because they're smaller and they feed closer to the energy or at the source of energy for the food web. They have larger population sizes, they're smaller bodied, so they reproduce much more quickly, they have shorter lifespans, faster turnover. With larger species, they have lower rates of reproduction, they take longer to mature, so their population turnover takes longer time. So as we harvest those species, it's more difficult for them to be replaced. Another really interesting reason to feed lower down in the food chain is because of pollution. And so as pollution enters into the ocean, it enters the food chain very close to the base. These are the very smallest microscopic consumers or small animal consumers like clams that are eating phytoplankton and are also picking up small traces of, for example, heavy metals, and they have small amounts in their bodies. As you move up the food chain or out the food web, we have something called biomagnification. So you have one clam that has a little bit of mercury in it, a stingray comes along, and the stingray will eat maybe 50 clams in a day. Then you have a shark that comes along, and that shark might consume, you know, in its lifetime, who knows how many stingrays. And then, of course, then a human consumes the shark. And so you end up with very increasingly high and lethal doses as you move up the food chain.
There are calculators that take into account your gender, age, and weight to determine how much you can eat of a specific fish. But in general, pregnant women and young kids should stay away from larger fish like tuna.
Should I stick with farmed fish then, like my trout here?
I mean, I wish I can tell you yes, but some of the farmed fish choices are terrible for the ocean.
It depends on the type of fish that you're farming. Salmon is farmed in these nets that are in the open ocean. You have fish who are being fed a lot in a small space and then excreting or letting go of that waste. And that's landing on the seafloor and getting carried by currents to other places. There's a lot of antibiotics and a lot of treatment that the salmon are getting to make sure that they don't get sick and infected. So that's another thing that's getting put into that environment. Tilapia is a species of fish that can be grown sustainably through aquaculture because it's not happening in the ocean, it's happening in a closed tank. So you're able to recirculate and filter all this water and it's not getting out anywhere else. Farmed trout is also another type of fish that is considered to be farmed more sustainably.
So you can still order fish, you just have to do your homework. Hey, you're here! Join us! Do you guys know what you want?
How are your clams harvested? Are they dredged or raked?
They're raked.
Great! Then I guess I'll have an order of the fried clams, please.
And I'll take the veggie burger.